Hey guys, this is Ray Bossa, leader of your nightmare, bringing you another video for our channel. This time we are not going to look at any clan war decks, but we are going to look at the Go Arch strategy while farming in champ. The Go Arch stands for golems and arches, in this particular case using two golems, one in the clan cost and one on your own, and the rest is arches, 210 to be exact. Why am I making this video, you may ask? That's because I've been doing a lot of reading on the Supercell forums and noticed that there are a lot of people complaining about the loot, having some loot problems. And I thought by myself, well, the problem is not there for me. I've been farming for over a year in the Champ League now, and loot has been great. I even managed, while making this video, to get my Archer Queen to level 40, and already busy trying to get my Barb King to level 40 as well. Walls are going great, all my defenses are maxed. And I also made a topic about this on the Supercell forums, doing an experiment. The experiment was 1 hour of hardcore farming, 15 hours to be exact, so an entire day. And after doing this, I made a summary of it, which was I gained almost 14 million gold in a day, 12 million elixir, and almost 110k dark elixir, which was pretty neat. It was a long day, not always going to do that. I do have work and other hobbies, but you don't need to gain 14 million gold every day. But 1 million per hour is nice. I don't think why it should be any better. It's still a game, there should still be a challenge. You cannot expect to gain 4 million every hour, which would mean you only will see max bases all over the place. And the max base, in my opinion, should be something special. Well, anyway, I started a topic on Supercell forum about it, and I noticed that, one, there was a lot of interest in it. A lot of people were curious about how to go Arch and Champ, and a lot were wondering, okay, the Go Arch strategy obviously works, but how to do it? What is Go Arch? What should I look for? Can you share some replays? So I thought, why not make this video and share some replays with you guys? To begin with, I managed to get 3 replays in order. I hope that's enough. I mean, Go Arch isn't rocket science. Every tech's pretty much the same. That makes it pretty neat. You can quickly have an army ready. It doesn't take a lot of lightning spells, doesn't take a lot of health from your heroes. So you can get a decent amount of attacks in every day, not a lot of waiting hours, not a lot of boost necessary, so it saves you some gems, and you can still get a lot of loot. So let's move on. The question is, what to look for when Go Arch? What are the rules? Well, I've written about 7. One of them is, if you do not have your Archer Queen, the most important one, bring a jump spell for your Barb King. Without a jump spell, your Barb King will just mesh against the walls for the majority of his time, and he will not gain any percentage for you. While in a jump spell, if it's not near any of the opponent heroes, it can easily destroy 5, 6, 7 buildings, which could mean 10% and to the 50%, which means the league bonus, and not losing any trophies for you. Second one is, only attack bases with enough buildings outside the walls. If all the buildings are inside the walls, it's almost impossible to gain the 50%. You're better off hitting the next button than trying to get to the 50%, fill your attacks and lose a lot of trophies, and if you continue to do that, be outside champ within no time. Also look for bases with outside storages if they are full, or if you notice that the opponent has a lot of loot, but the storages seem to be empty, it's most likely new collectors. Collectors are almost always on the outside, and you can still gain a lot of loot, if not all. Check for giant bombs in obvious places by dropping an archer, single archer. There are sometimes, you will also see this in the replays, a lot of giant bombs in obvious places. You're better off dropping 5 to 7 archers. Get the giant bombs. A couple of, perhaps even all of them. It saves you that the giant bomb destroys the majority of your archers. Risk not getting to 50%. Next one is destroy the unreachable buildings which cannot be hit by defensive buildings first before deploying your golems. The most important one, point 6, decide where to drop your golems. Always focus on X-bows, mortars and whiz towers. These three buildings are the ones who can easily destroy all your archers. So you want them focused on your golems while your archers either take out those or get to the 50% before the golem dies. Avoid inferno towers. If your golem get the attraction from an inferno tower, it will only take a couple of seconds before your golem is gone, and all the buildings, all the defensive buildings, will focus on your archers. And avoid dropping a golem near the clan castle. Let those troops stay warm inside. I mean, it's not that important, but if you have the option, try not the to drop a golem near the clan castle. The clan castle troops will come out and cause panic for your archers and destroy your golem real quickly. And the last one, deploy all archers equally around the base. Use the multi-touch method, multiple fingers on your screen, and just slide them all around the base. Well, that's enough. Let's see the replays. And if you have any questions after the replay, watching replays, do not hesitate to give us a Twitter message. Visit our website or our channel for more tips, or even join our website for just some tips, just some discussions. You are free and welcome for a cup of coffee. Enjoy seeing this, guys, and I hope it's a good study material and helps you out with your farming. Alright, guys, this is the first Go Architect. As you can see, fantastic loot. The guy got a lot of gold, a lot of elixir and dark elixir, so I'm just trying to get it all. Great Go Arch base, why? Because there are a lot of outside buildings, and having outside buildings means the archers don't have to shoot over the walls and can easily destroy the outside buildings without too much defensive buildings interfering. Okay, before we start, before you're gonna drop your golems and all your archers, you gotta follow a few rules, a few steps. Steps one is check for giant bombs. As you can see, this is the same thing I did. Hop, drop a couple of archers here and there. Here goes the giant bomb. Here's the giant bomb. And it's just looking for obvious locations. So I thought here could be one, here could be one, here to the left, perhaps be in front of the gold storage. And you can, it's better to just drop a couple of archers and waste them when there are not any giant bombs. But if they are, they will save your troops big time and help you in your victory to 50%. Second step is destroy any unreachable buildings. It just takes one archer. You have all the time in the world with Go Arch. Just take one archer to destroy an unreachable building, and it gives you a couple of percentage. It clears the way to other buildings. A couple more archers there. This one wasn't reachable. This one is. I will fast forward it. And as you can see, I take the time. I just wait for the buildings to clear, because it just takes around 40 seconds with Go Arch to finish your attack and get to the 50%. And as you can see, all buildings are gone and it's time to drop in the golems. Okay, that's another point. When you drop golems, you want to decide where to drop them. One of the most important factors is always drop them where there are mortars, whiz towers and or X-bows. Those are the troops which kill your archers the most, so you want those buildings to focus on your golems, so your archers have all the time in the world, or all the time they need, to get to the 50% and get the most important buildings where the gold is, the elixir and the dark elixir. You don't want to drop your golems in front of infernos, because it just takes a couple of seconds and the golems are gone. And you want to try to avoid dropping them near a clan castle, because you don't want the clan castle troops to come out. Archers will focus on the clan castle troops, forgetting about destroying the buildings, and you might not get to the 50%. Let's continue with this attack. As you can see, I dropped the golem here. This was important because I knew there were Teslas, I knew there was a mortar, an X-bow, another archer tower. And I dropped one here, the golem, to go for both mortars, both whiz towers, and an expo and two archer towers. So a lot of defensive buildings focused on the golems. And as you can see, I just swipe with four fingers and drop all the archers around the base, getting the most important buildings, the storages, and getting close to the 50%. As you will notice, I do not get exactly to the 50%. I get stuck on 46, but I have a Barb King with me, an Archer Queen, and 5 Lightning Spells. So I knew when I ended on 46% that this would be an easy victory. It's just a matter of deciding where do you want to drop the heroes. What is important when dropping the heroes, for example, you can see the Clan Castle troops are out. So dropping your Barb King or Archer Queen here will mean they'll get focused on killing all the Clan Castle troops, which take time, they might even die, and the defensive buildings have time to destroy your heroes. Also, you don't want to drop them near one of the heroes. These are centralized, but if they are more to the outside and you drop the hero towards the heroes, they get focused on killing the hero. The hero tries to kill your hero and you won't get that remaining 4%. And as you can see, I dropped the Barb King here. He will die a bit, but I thought, why not try to get the elixir that was left. And I don't need the Barb King that much with Go Arch. I won't even boost him to try to heal him and just let him heal by himself and go on. And of course, I wanted to get the Dark Elixir storage. So I dropped the Archer Queen there and made it invincible. And as you can see, easy 50%, quitting immediately. And I got all the loot, 4 trophies, perfect attack. Alright guys, here's another example of the Go Arch attack in Champ. As you can see, this looks like a base that has been attacked before. Looking at the tombstones, could be a trick. But since there is 4.2k Dark Elixir available and his storage is empty, I thought this guy has not been online for a while. So I thought, what the heck, why not drop the golems here and here, let them focus on the heroes, the mortar, 2 mortars even, here mortar, and both wish towers. I wanted to go for the drills and for the storage, so I could get all the Dark Elixir. So basically, I did not even take a look at how much gold or elixir you had. I'm farming for Dark Elixir here, for my heroes. And I wanted that 4.2k, with a 1.2k bonus. It's a decent amount of Dark Elixir. I mean, 40 of those, and you have maxed your storage. Since he has been attacked, I did not bother to check for giant bombs. I just went right in, dropped it near the wish towers. And as you can see, archers all over the place. And this will be an easy victory. It's a great base. Another reason why I didn't look for any giant bombs is because this is a base with so many open spots that I thought, one, he will have his Teslas inside, probably here too. And most of the giant bombs will be located in his base and not outside his base. And we can just take a quick look at how easy it is with Go Arch to get to the 50%, and how rarely you need any heroes or lightning spells, especially lightning spells. You can save them, saves a boost, saves the elixir. And as you can see, I end up with 47%. And now it's time to look, okay, how can I get the remaining 3% without letting my heroes die, so I can use them again. I don't want them to be interfering with the heroes there, to be distracted. I also don't want to drop them, for example, here, so they can destroy 1 or 2 buildings and shoot at the wall. So I thought, hey, archers are killing that wall anyway, let's just wait for it and use these 3 buildings to get to the 50%, even though I knew probably 2 buildings were more than enough. I will fast forward it. And there goes the wall, there comes my Archer Queen, And it is an easy 50%. Guys, my third and final goal arch replay to show you guys. I hope 3 is enough. I mean, if you want more or if it's something unclear, please let me know. I'm more than happy to help out and perhaps even release a second video for you guys. Well, this is an interesting one. Why I chose this one? Because as you can see, he had the loot. Definitely some gold and elixir there. Also, I noticed that the gold and elixir were not in the storages, but probably in the collectors. But more importantly, I noticed his dark elixir amount. And when I see 6k, I know I want it all. But what I also noticed was a lot were probably in the boosted collectors, but also some in the storage. I noticed he's been attacked, so probably an empty clan castle. I hope some giant bombs were taken out in the process. Tesla's probably in the center. Shouldn't be too much of a problem. Giant bombs probably here near the golems, near the mortars and near the whist towers. But I don't want to get to there. I want to stay center to the left near the dark elixir collectors and storages. So when I hit the play button, you can see I dropped some archers here to check out for some giant bombs. Not too many, because it's a base that has been attacked. So probably not any giant bombs left. And now I thought, what the heck, why not drop the golems near the dark elixir storage and just get this part of the damage and some around it to get 50%. So you can see two golems dropped, here comes the archers, also some archers here in this area to get the gold mines with the loot. As you can see, a lot of loot in the mines and collectors. A bit more archers on the left side to get all the surrounding buildings. Let the archer queen focus on the center, force her towards the center, and you can see that it works pretty well. Archers doing their job fine. Golem keep getting the attention, especially this big fella, and the archer queen already in the center, already 44%. And we are getting somewhere now. Archers helping the archer queen getting through the wall. And go girl, go for that storage. Here you go. Interesting thing about the end of this attack, because I was not yet at 50%. I noticed when I boosted the archer queen, she went for a second for the clan castle, which would have made it 50%. But the archer queen was still alive of the opponent. And I noticed that in the middle, she suddenly was focused on getting through the wall to get to the archer queen. So I thought, I don't want to boost her. She wasn't boosted already. So let's just get the big fella out and let the barbarian king get that 1% at the right side. Quick change of mind. And here you go. 50% done business. Quickly end the match. Heroes unharmed. And as you can see, the full 6k dark elixir, adding the bonus of 1.2k, makes it a whopping 7.2k dark elixir. And another successful raid without any spells, without any harm to the heroes. And you can quickly come back to your army camps and attack again. Alright guys, so there you have it, a couple of examples on how to go arch in champ as a farming method or even as a trophy hunting method. I mean, I almost made it to 4k trophies myself using only go arch, so it is possible without costing you too much money for the gems. Well, enjoy. I hope it was helpful, this tutorial. And if you have any questions, you can always ask us on Twitter at Clash of Clans EU, in our YouTube channel, or visit us in-game. All details are below in this video. Clash on, guys, and see you next video. Bye all.